this is Young Guru, and welcome to the MPC University. Today we're going to cover one of my favorite topics, sampling. How do we get information into the MPC Renaissance? You can sample from any of the inputs on the back of the MPC. For today, I pulled out the old turntable and felt like we should do some vinyl. So today we'll be sampling one of my favorite songs, T Plays It Cool, off the Marvin Gaye record, Troubled Man. First thing I want to do is go into record sample mode. I'll hold shift, hit sample edit, and that will allow me to see my screen where I can view my levels and adjust depending on the level of the record. I would play my record, turn my record gain, make sure that I'm not clipping. I can hit reset peak just to check. And when I'm ready, I can hit record. I hit stop. Here's where I can name my sample. Let's call this T Cool. I can assign it to a pad. Let's say A1, or I can simply hit the pad to assign it. And if I'm dealing with the key group, I can assign the root note. I can play it back, decide if I want to keep it. If I don't like it, I can hit retry. I like this sample, so let's press keep. In order to trim my sample, I'll simply hit sample edit, which will give me a lot of options on how I want to trim my sample. Using my cue links, I can adjust the beginning and the end. I can decide whether I want to snap to zero, which will allow me only to move the cursor to places that are at the cross zero point, which will make sure that I don't have any clips. As you can see, the cue links are divided into thousands, hundreds, tens, and ones. I would hold my pad and adjust my sample. By hitting the edit button, I can pull up and process the sample. I can discard, which will throw away the ends that I don't want. I can delete certain parts, silence certain parts, or I can extract new samples out of this original sample. I can normalize, I can reverse the sample. I can choose a fade in or a fade out. I can pitch shift, I can change the gain, and I can even time stretch. The MPC Renaissance allows you to do a great bit reduction. I can take a stereo sample and make it mono, or I can copy a section of my sample. For now, let's just use discard. Now that we loaded our sample, I wanted to load some drums and show you exactly how the chop feature works inside the MPC Renaissance. So I'll move to some drums that I have, and I'll move over to the chop. Now here, we can chop according to the threshold, by regions, or by the BPM. For now, let's chop to the threshold. As I move to my threshold and I start to turn up, you see that the MPC will automatically chop according to the transients of the sample. Another great feature is that you can test every region by pressing the pads. Once I have the chop the way that I want it, I can hit convert. Now I can convert to patch phrases. I can convert to slice samples, where if I have crop sample on, it will cut off all the samples. If I turn off crop sample, my chops will now have beginning and end points that I can further adjust. I can create a new program out of this. And I can also create events. We will create the MIDI event and lay it out on my sequencer. Let's turn these on. How many bars do I want? Let's say 2. And let's do it. Now when I come back to my main page, the MPC Renaissance has created a sequence out of my drum pattern. I can adjust the tempo. slices will follow. If I go back into my sample edit, I can also convert and assign slices to specific pads. Now that I've finished editing all of my samples, I can go back to my main page and make my beat. This is Young Guru, and this has been the MPC University. And as always, make sure you stay tuned to akaipro.com for all further updates.